And the Sharks, Daryl Sutter wants more out of his best players, including Andre Kopitar.
It goes back farther than that for Kopitar. One goal in his last 25 games. There seems to be a real clunkiness to Kopitar's game. The separation of one stride to get away from a defender to create some room doesn't seem to be there. As Kopitar goes, that top line with Brown and Williams go, and they have to answer what the Sharks' top players have done, in particular the game-winning goal of Logan Couture in Game 3.
And a lot of focus on Jonathan Quick. He has seen a lot more traffic than Antti Niemi and was given a game misconduct at the conclusion of Game 3. Game 4 is underway. Drew Doughty back to get it. Kopitar, Brown, and Williams up against Pavelski, Couture, and Patrick Marleau. There's Justin Braun playing it back inside the Los Angeles zone, and Quick out as the fans chanting early. Here's Kopitar to work over the line with Williams. They can't bust in, and Pavelski will turn back. Justin Braun ahead. That's off the stick of Marleau in on Quick, and Jonathan Quick will be a focus tonight.
As if things aren't tough enough for that top line for the Kings. Watch Dustin Brown here. Center ice play, 23. He and Marleau run together in the middle of the ice. They don't see each other. And Brown is shaken up down on the ice. He's sitting at the far end of the Kings bench, but a quick early shift and bump for Dustin Brown.
Jeff Carter on this faceoff against Thornton, who gets waved. So it'll be Gagliardi in on the draw. He wins it. Scott Hannon's shot is off target. Dwight King on the near side. This has been the best line for LA in the series, but Thornton's been very good as well. Look for Hannon on the left flank. Now Burns crashing in there. Gagliardi comes up with it, looking for his first playoff points. Into the slot, rolls it forward, and Voinov there cutting it off in front of Thornton. Thornton retrieves it again, sends it around to the near side. Veteran Brad Stewart on the backhand, shoveled it in front, loose for Gagliardi, who can't pull the trigger, and Carter will advance for the Kings. Jeff Carter over the line, holds on, now centers. Thornton back defensively. There's Voinov in, back to Carter, who heels that into the corner. Richards goes after it. Muzzin sends it wide. Here's Scott Gomez. The third line checks in for the Sharks, and Gomez is bumped. Brad Stewart up ahead for Tommy Wingles, and he'll chip it in. And there goes James Shepherd after it, along with Gomez. Sent by Muzzin to the left side for Dustin Penner. And now loose for Muzzin, and there's Matt Green making his first appearance of the series. And his first appearance for the Kings since late April. Just 5 regular season games for the alternate captain and veteran defenseman.
Really plays a key role for Daryl Sutter when he's healthy. He's missed most of this year, as you mentioned, but he gives him another right shot, a physical presence on that third pair that they've scrambled to replace all year.
So Green for Ellerby, and Kyle Clifford is in the lineup for the LA Kings, and just coming over the boards now. He'll take a spot on the fourth line that Tanner Pearson occupied in Game 3. There's Clifford after it, just coming back. First time in this series. Last game, Game 5 against St. Louis. Daryl Sutter hasn't been happy with his fourth line for most of the year, and certainly not in the postseason.
They've moved their left wingers around a lot this year. They don't really seem to be that comfortable with it. Jordan Nolan was really good in the playoffs last year. He's had a disappointing year. Dwight King has been a non-factor for most of the season. And so they've scrambled around on that left side, and that throws that whole fourth line mix into disarray for Daryl Sutter. The weakness or the book on Niemi's, get it into his feet, make him control the rebound. Carter's got to shoot that puck, especially with his release. You've got players going to the front of the net, and Richards and King, he pulls up. The potential rebound has gone away, and it's an easy one for Niemi because he doesn't have to do anything.
Faceoff win by Pavelski, but Boyle can't funnel the shot through. At center, Colin Fraser moves up, but Couture comes back to get it. Fourth line would like to get off. As Boyle hitmans the puck over the line, Pavelski got it back again. Now Marleau will follow. They team the bouncing puck. Marleau a shot right on. Rebound, and Couture had a try. And Jonathan Quick with back-to-back stops. The big line for the Sharks. with early chances. Pavelski gets worked over by Rob Scuderi. They continue the board battle. It's pried loose by Couture. Sends it back for Pavelski. Marlowe in front, and the wrap by Pavelski doesn't work. Away goes Dustin Brown, so Brown doesn't miss a shift after that hit by Marlowe at center ice, and offside is the call at the Kings line, or Sharks line.
Joe Pavelski had an assist, plays 23 minutes the last couple of nights for the Sharks. Watch this little bit of puck work here. Through the feet of Justin Williams, Marlowe shot quickly through the screen of Couture and the quickness of Jonathan Quick to get the right leg flat again. And Pavelski's minutes have climbed as he's moved from that third line center into the top six role along with Couture and Marlowe.
Matchups have been pretty consistent in this series, and once again the Thornton line is on the ice against the Richards line for the Kings.
Todd McLellan seems pretty comfortable with Joe Thornton playing in the middle of that matchup against Mike Richards. If he has to go against Kopitar, they don't worry about that either. But moving Pavelski up into that second line with the injuries that they've had in the suspension to Torres really takes away some of their depth that was such a strength against the Canucks.
Thornton wins the faceoff back in his own zone. He has dominated the faceoff circle since Jarrett Stoll left this series. Last two games, Thornton has won 26 of 37. There's Robin Regier back for the icing touch-up.
He's dominated the faceoff circle, in particular to the right of Jonathan Quick. Another place where Joe Thornton has had a terrific playoff is his goal differential. Not plus-minus, but goal differential. Only been on for one goal against, 15-4. You see the other leaders, Nathan Horton, Krejci, and Lucic in Boston. They play as a line. Thornton's playing with a converted defenseman in TJ Gagliardi, who doesn't have any points this playoffs. It's really quite remarkable his goals for and against are what they are.
Interesting, that stat is one that Daryl Sutter puts a lot of value on. He mentioned this morning his biggest concern right now is the play of Joe Thornton. There goes Gagliardi after it, chips it to Burns, a centering pass, intercepted by Kopitar, who comes back defensively. Dishes to the left wing, and away goes Justin Williams. Here's Williams trying to get a shot through. His own rebound, but he couldn't make contact with that bouncing puck. Ice has been talked about here as an issue, and a shot goes wide. A rebound by Shepherd, and Quick got across, and now, scrambling, he'll freeze the puck for a faceoff.
In game three, the ice was a condition was an issue condition-wise, as both teams said it was sticky and sloppy as the game went on. Early in the game here, it doesn't appear to be many pucks bouncing around, but look at this rather athletic, awkward save by Quick. He spins all the way around in his net. I don't know another goaltender that would do that in the NHL today. That looks, when I watch Jonathan Quick, it looks a lot like Dominic Hasek to me. It looks improvised, yet there is such a base of flexibility and athleticism to it that he stops the puck with the middle of his body more often than not.
Faceoff won by the Sharks. Matt Irwin sends it around. Boyle moves up. Puck got past him, and Shepherd will walk in and shoot it, and that was blocked by Trevor Lewis. Here's Irwin again. Cut off by Muzzin, an outlet for Penner. He'll chip it ahead, and racing after it, the hero of game two, Trevor Lewis. In support is Tyler Toffoli. Toffoli with the Kings' lone goal in game three. No player in this series has more than one goal so far. Muzzin for Lewis. In behind the net is Toffoli. He's knocked off the puck, and Matt Irwin's got it up for Wingles, and he'll backhand it out. The Sharks want to change. Slavovoynov, right side. Jeff Carter loose, and that shot handled by Niemi. And he'll hold on. The NHL on TSN Stanley Cup Playoffs is brought to you by Chevrolet. Find new roads.
Chris, you talked about the addition of Matt Green to the lineup. Look what he adds. He absolutely smothers Scott Gomez to the right of Jonathan Quick. And why that's important, there's been much talk about the aggressiveness of Quick, why he wants to, or how he wants to get to the top of the crease. Green clears a little more space that allows Quick to get out to where he wants to be.
Referees Chris Rooney, Brad Meyer, Scott Driscoll, and Derek Amell are on the lines. Pass at center for Thornton. Carter comes back, regains possession for the Kings and sends it inside the line. Brad Stewart back to get it for San Jose. There's Dwight King on the forecheck. Richards arrives, but Gagliardi sends it to center. It got past Stewart. Richards got onside. Gagliardi comes back to get it for the Sharks. Sent down the ice. Voinov lost it to Thornton. He looks for Burns on the shot right on. Loose puck. Scores! Brent Burns!
Burns cashes a fabulous play by Joel Thornton. This is rather Pavel Datsyukian as he chases the puck down the ice. Watch him retrieve the puck. Little stick lift of Voinov. Burns stopped once and then Thornton right through the crowd. No chance for Jonathan Quick. Brent Burns had a tremendous game three. He was active all over the ice. He had three hits and three shots. Here he makes no mistake and the Sharks have the game's first goal.
Second of the playoff for Burns. Thornton adds another point to his total. And so he's now been on the ice for 16-4 and one against.
What a nice play by Thornton to get to the puck. First he hustles to it and then catch Voinov from behind to lift the stick and find Burns twice for the goal.
So the Sharks score first for the second consecutive game here at HP Pavilion. An even strength goal. And of the 13 goals in the series, 8 at even strength. So Burns from Thornton at 6:09, the scoring play. Up off Andrew Desjardins. It'll roll down into King's ice, buzzing back to get it. He lost it there on the board checking there as Kennedy and Kearns arrive for San Jose. There's Matt Green, an outlet onto the right side for Brad Richardson. He played it inside the line, knocked down and played to an open wing. Back in LA ice. Colin Fraser, now Kyle Clifford off his skates to the attack goes Clifford. He'll add a little oomph to this Kings forecheck with his size and strength.
Darryl Sutter calls it meat, adds more meat to the lineup.
There's a shot knocked down in front. Tommy Wingles has provided that for the Sharks. He leads the series in hits and is up to 36 on the playoffs for San Jose. Bodies crash, but Dwight King out with the puck looking for Carter. Chasing it down in San Jose ice against Scott Hannon. Dwight King arrives. And then it's Gomez finding it and taking off. 3-on-2 break. Gomez in the middle. Stewart tried to swing it to the right side. Out of the reach of Gagliardi. There's the goal scorer, Burns, sending it back in. Burns directed 12 shots at the net in game three. Three got through. He had 7 blocked in that game. But he has the first goal of game four. And Thornton swooping in again. That one blocked by Doughty. Picked up by Burns. Sends it in behind the net. Thornton looking for it there. Got by him. Brad Stewart pitching down the wall. Thornton picks the pocket of Richards. And Joe Thornton is having a heck of an opening period. Back to Hannon. And his shot doesn't get through. Off the skate of Carter, who thought about going to the bench and now will.
Well, what a start for Joe Thornton. What a start for the Sharks. The Kings just 2 shots in the first 9 minutes.
Now Couture to the attack, into the skates of Marlowe. Pavelski follows up. Logan Couture centers and Marlowe taps it wide of the net. Couture leaves it for Marlowe. He'll cycle it to Pavelski. And the Sharks are circling here in the opening 10 minutes. Boyle off the side of the net. Penner will send it around. There's Matt Irwin stepping up. Couture again. Penner drapes him along the boards. Puck is loose. Pavelski wins a battle. Dan Boyle to the front of the net as it's off Quick up into the air and back into his glove. And Quick with a little glove push on Pavelski. But all Sharks early.
Communication is vital defensively. Here is TJ Gagliardi. He's in the middle of the ice. He's normally a winger. He's not sure where to go. He's looking around. Joe Thornton is telling him, get over down low and support the puck. He gives him a little shoe with his stick. Well, the Sharks are able to break the puck out of the zone. And because Thornton's in good position defensively, he's going to chase this puck down, eventually going to get down to the loose puck behind the net for Voinoff, where he gets to it, lifts his stick, but that all starts with communication. At the other end of the ice, Gagliardi ends up in a support position. Thornton ends up with some loose ice, and he finds Brent Burns for the goal.
Faceoff win by Couture. Bounced into the corner by Vlasic. Sent past Marleau, and now Justin Williams down the right side. Kopitar catching up on the rush. Williams playing it onto the net, where Niemi holds on. The NHL on TSN Stanley Cup Playoffs brought to you by Molson Canadian, proud partner of the NHL. Molson Canadian, made from Canada.
The Kings have three shots in the first 10 minutes. This is the second one from way out on the wing like this. Kopitar snow showers Niemi, but zero scoring chances in 10 minutes for the Kings. They've been outshot in this series, an average of 9 shots per game. And in the first period of every game, they've been outshot 11-4 in game 2, 14-11 in game 3, tonight 7-3. And it's been remarkable how difficult it's been, Chris, for the Kings to generate shots in this series.
Daryl Sutter concerned about that. Said this morning, we've got our hands full, and that's been the case so far in the opening period of game 4. Gagliardi to the attack. There's Thornton. Knocked down by Regier. Thornton gets it back. Curls inside the line. And then gives it up, but gets it back again. Thornton looks back. Cannon shot. And Quick just got a piece of that. Dangerous shot from the point from Scott Hannon. Burns goes after. Comes up with a puck against Regier. Thornton in support. This is Thornton's best period of the playoffs, and he's been a factor. Center, Gagliardi stopped by Quick. It gets back to Hannon, his shot off Gagliardi, and Dowdy comes up with it at the side of the open net.
Well, Daryl Sutter may want to rethink this Mike Richards line against Joe Thornton, at least for right now. They have been dominated in this first period by Joe Thornton, TJ Gagliardi, and Brent Burns.
It'll come back to the point. That shot knocked down through a screen by Quick and out beyond the blue paint. And the fur starts to fly in front of the Kings netminder as the Sharks' pressure continues.
What a dominant period for Joe Thornton. Look at the play he makes here. He passes it off the boards to himself, spins, and then finds Scott Hannon through the seam for a scoring chance. Nice save by Jonathan Quick. And then now the Kings are running all over the place. Thornton's got two options. He goes across the seam to Gagliardi. Another stop for Jonathan Quick as Joe Thornton has had the puck on his stick most of the first 11 minutes of this first period.
Extra day off, and he's got plenty of jump, doesn't he?
He has been so strong on the puck. When Joe gets tired, you really notice it in his skating. He's such a big man. He has been quick to the puck. He's been first to loose pucks. He's had a tremendous start to this hockey game.
Gomez a face-off win. They've won 10 of 12. Puck to the side of the net. Gomez is there. Shots are 9-3. The scoring chances 7-0. And the score 1-0 San Jose. Gene Shepard trying to get away from Jake Muzzin. In there as well, Trevor Lewis, dugout, and Penner onto the right side for Toffoli to the red line, and he'll bounce it in. There's Dan Boyle losing an edge, but the Kings have retreated on a change. Now out comes Colin Fraser along with Richardson and Clifford to the attack. It's Desjardins sending it wide of the net. Far side, it's Tim Kennedy, the former Buffalo Sabre, in behind. Centered it, and Desjardins unable to reach that. And Richardson will backhand it into the bench and out of play. A faceoff back in the Kings zone.
Daryl Sutter went with his fourth line, and you saw a real aggressive attempt on the forecheck by Clifford and Richardson. Now here's another play from below the goal line. The Kings' coverage has been abysmal here in the first period for a team that usually does a real good job defensively. They've struggled with the Sharks in this series. They gave up 35 shots the first game, 31 the second game, 40 the third game. Now they've given up 9 already, and the quality of chances they've given up has been alarming from a Kings standpoint.
Kopitar waved here. Couture at 63%. Won another faceoff, and that's glove and held by Quick.
Without Jarrett Stoll in the lineup, now you're asking other guys to win a faceoff. And the one thing that the Kings have been miserable at is winning them in their own zone. They've lost all 6 of them so far tonight. And at this point, what you're asking your centermen to do is don't get beat cleanly. Try and tie the draw. Try and scuttle it so we can get to loose pucks. Here, Richards and Thornton wins the draw by himself again.
Another one of those faceoff wins where he wins it to himself along the boards. So 7 for 7 in the offensive zone. Drew Doughty unable to catch up to that. Look at Brad Stewart in deep, and now Richards will get control. This has been the best line for the Kings in the series. But the Mike Richards group has been hemmed in for most of this first period. Off Dwight King deep. Scott Hannon is back in his own zone. Along the wall, Carter had it, lost it. James Sheppard, toe pick there around the blue line, and then gets knocked over by King. Dwight King's got it. Fraser off the bench, goes to the front of the net. Dwight King tries to center it. Now Fraser is after it against Stewart. Richardson in support. Fraser from his knees gets up and pushes it to the corner. There goes Clifford. Tried to feed the point, but that was intercepted, and James Sheppard will send it in. Wingles on the far side is bumped by Voinov. Brad Richards, who led the Kings the last time these two teams met. We've got the penalty, and the first penalty of the game will go against LA. And it's a hooking call going against Colin Fraser.
Not the energetic start that Daryl Sutter was hoping for his Kings. Pinch on the boards by Marlowe. There's the hook and trip by Colin Fraser. We'll go back and look at this faceoff by Thornton. The defenseman here for the Kings is the only guy that can retrieve this puck. Thornton's going to shoot it to the boards. The defenseman goes immediately with Brent Burns. Burns' play is just to obstruct so Thornton can get to the puck. As soon as Thornton lines up like that, Chris, the defenseman has to be able to read that he's not going forward with it. He's just shooting it to the boards. You can let Burns go to get to the puck first.
Sharks were 2 for 5 in game 3, 2 for 12 in the series. And looking for a 2-goal lead here in the opening period with the power play. Dan Boyle left it. Pavelski over to Marlowe trying to flip it in, and it will be sent back. Broken up by Drew Doughty. Boyle at the wheel. Couture, Doughty meets him. Boyle sends it wide of the net. It finds Thornton. Couture now, who scored the power play overtime winner 3 nights ago. Into the middle, Marlowe shot is high and out of play.
What a well-constructed power play the Sharks have shown in these playoffs. They scheme very well. They support the puck extremely well. Watch how they get this puck off the boards. Thornton gets it. He's not even looking except over a quick look over his shoulder. He puts it right in the middle of the ice to the puck support of Logan Couture. Now they use the middle of the ice again, and it's Marlowe with a scoring chance. We saw them do this to Vancouver. They've done it here against LA in the last couple of games in particular.
Lewis and Richardson, the penalty killers, a pass in front. Gagliardi unable to tip, and it's sent down the ice by the Kings. Second power play group has Gagliardi, Wingles, Gomez, Burns, and Irwin. Here's TJ Gagliardi over the line, chipping it past Scuderi, a chance for Green. Didn't get much on it. It does arrive for Richardson, and now Lewis chops at it. Held in by Irwin. Backed up by Wingles. Played over to the near side for Brent Burns. Into Wingles' corner. Tracked there by Scuderi. Gomez back. Room for Burns. Fires right on. And again, Quick out beyond the blue paint to make the stop and get the glove up on Wingles in front.
poor discipline by Jonathan Quick. He's real close to a penalty there. We saw him flip a screw in overtime after the game-winning goal. But on the first goal of the game, he was complaining about interference. If I'm the Sharks, I stand right on top of him the rest of the night. Anytime he goes out of the crease, I try and just put a little tap on the back of his hands. I want to drive him crazy. Well done by Matt Green to keep Tommy Wingles out of the front of the net. That's a little tap there. That's nothing, but it's the punch to the face here to Wingles that Quick's going to have to be careful about.
Daryl Sutter says he's got to manage it. Did you think that the response at the end of game three was a sign that the Sharks are getting to him?
No, I thought he was sour at the calls. I thought he was frustrated. The one that I thought he was most upset with really was the first goal of the game, the Boyle power play goal.
Under 5 minutes remaining here in the opening period. 10 seconds left in the penalty to Fraser. He stands in the box ready to return. Vlasic wide off Dowdy. That'll be a slashing penalty, and one penalty killed. Another one is pending.
What is he thinking? That is an absurd penalty for Drew Doughty to take. For a Stanley Cup champion team, they have no composure right now.
They took three penalties in the final 6 minutes of game three, and back-to-back penalties here in the opening period of game four.
I'm not real sure what Drew Doughty's thinking here. This is about as obvious a slashing penalty as you can make, and it's on Mark-Edward Vlasic. Really undisciplined play by Doughty. The Kings are running all over their zone, but Chris, if they can somehow get out of this period here, this is pretty much the Sharks' best shot. But they got to kill another penalty. They're second of the period.
Probably as poorly as they've played for 15 minutes in the playoffs, and yet just a one-goal deficit. Scuderi intercepts and clears. So a big penalty kill for the Kings with Kopitar and Brown out. Matt Green and Scuderi, veteran blue line, as Dan Boyle leads the attack. Marleau over the line. He gets knocked down by Green. Kopitar looks for it. Boyle finds it. It'll be Pavelski with a shot right on. Rebound. Green chops at it. And it ricochets back into the glove of Quick with Thornton on the doorstep.
Now puck bouncing all over the place before Jonathan Quick can finally get a handle on it. Quick's been busy. 11 shots here in the first 15 minutes and so of game time. The Kings are leaning on him here. This reminds me back to the start of their series against St. Louis last year, where they were outplayed badly early in the series, and Quick held them in until they got their feet underneath them again.
Another face-off win. Marleau breaks his stick. He'll have to go to the bench for a new cue as Thornton works the boards. Pavelski there. It's loose, and Jeff Carter's got it. And Voinov was going to step up. He'll retreat. Boyle gets control. Here's Pavelski, rink wide off the skeet of Marleau. Patrick Marleau. Now Thornton on the near side. It gets by him, and away goes Carter with Richards. Pavelski has to get back defensively. Carter's shot off the stick of Boyle to the corner. Now Couture with a quick lead. Up for Thornton over the line. Took a look. Guys changing, and he'll spot Gagliardi off the bench. TJ Gagliardi moving in. Quick down, and Gagliardi knocked down at the lip of the crease.
Really clever drive of the net by Gagliardi, but the part I liked best was he didn't make contact with the goaltender. With so much talk about it now, if he runs into Jonathan Quick, he's going to get a penalty here. But Gagliardi sees a little bit of an opening. He's going to try and go between Scuderi and Quick. Quick, really nice play to keep the paddle flat. Scuderi took the cross seam away, and Gagliardi's net drive is foiled.
Chatted with Gagliardi this morning, who says Quick is talking more and more in this series. They've got something going in a half. He said Quick's the most aggressive goaltender they face in the league. Irwin across, Gomez to the point. Burns looks for a tip in front off the stick of Gagliardi and knocked down by Lewis, who clears it. A couple dozen seconds remaining in the Doughty slashing penalty with under three left here in an opening period where the ice has been tilted. Gomez to work. Wingles over the line. Shot off the post. Oh, he rigged that up, and Quick finds the rebound off iron as as Tommy Wingles has a chance for his first ever Stanley Cup playoff goal.
Wow, what a release. Beat Jonathan Quick from the middle of the ice up over the glove, but it hits the crossbar and stays in front of the goal line. See Quick, he's out on top of his crease. He just gets beat on it, and you see the puck bounce straight down and land in front of the goal line. Not much question, it's not in the net, but what a shot by Tommy Wingles up over the glove of Jonathan Quick.
So Quick saves and a post, and it remains a one-goal lead. Another face-off win. Braun shot and a toe stop by Quick. With traffic in front, Pavelski was on the doorstep. Doughty back onto the ice. So the Kings have killed a pair of first period San Jose power plays. Now can they get this game tilted in the other direction? Back in comes Braun, Justin Braun. Unable to get a shot off, and Kopitar will turn it north. Onto the right side for Williams, knocked away from him. Kings will have to start again.
Look, Chris, nothing is clean for the Kings when they come out of their zone. There's no direct pass. They don't attack out of their zone as a unit of five.
And here's Thornton, got a little room, puts on the brakes. Burns stepped into that, and a stop by Quick. Brent Burns really leaned into that tee up from Thornton. Brad Stewart off the boards, out at center. And here's Scuderi. Flipping it down into the Shark zone. Hannon up ahead. Desjardins took a hit but got it away, and the fourth liners get it deep for San Jose. There's Bracken Kearns arriving. Scuderi on him. Rob Scuderi paired tonight with Drew Doughty. That pair from last year's Stanley Cup playoffs has been reunited for the first time in this series on a regular basis. Mike Richards, right wing pass, and Wingles got a stick in the lane. Richards ahead. Toffoli gets it in. And there goes Dwight King after it. Heavy hit in the corner on Gomez. Final minute of this first period. Board battle. Stewart knocks a man down. Shepard looking for it, and an outlet for Mark Edward Vlasic. Red line and deep. Matt Green back in his own zone, absorbs the hit from Shepard. Muzzin worked his man over Braun. That one knocked down with a high stick, and they'll have a face-off to the right of Jonathan Quick. Closed captioning brought to you by Steel. Built to last. Price to sell.
This will be the 22nd face-off of the first period. 15 of them have been in the Los Angeles Kings zone, as the Sharks have dominated this period territorially. But the Kings are 35 seconds about away from getting out of here just down 1-0, which would have to qualify as some kind of moral victory for them.
Sharks have won 76% of the draws. And make it better, there's a rebound, and Kennedy just missed as Quick was able to knock that to the corner. It's been almost 10 minutes since the last shot by the Kings. Shots now 15-3 in this opening period. Rob Scuderi sent it across in front of the net, and that went off Kennedy and bounded out to center. Tim Kennedy with it there. He's tied up by Pennard. And now the Kings with maybe one last chance here. Scuderi's in deep, centering it. That goes off Niemi. Braun up with it, and the period will come to a close. And the most positive for the Kings is that it's only 1-0 on a goal by Brent Burns. 15-3 the shots after 20 minutes, as we send it to Gene Duthie in the panel for our first intermission.
For the Kings, 3 for the Sharks.
1-0 lead for San Jose as we head to the second period of game 4. We talked a lot about Joe Thornton, and for good reason, but his line mates with their best period of the playoffs too.
Not even close for TJ Gagliardi. I thought by far his most effective period. He used his speed to get in on the forecheck. He was involved getting to the front of the net and creating traffic. Brent Burns, I thought, had a real feisty game 3. He had 3 hits and 3 blocks. He had the goal in the first period. But this line's energy, in particular in the offensive zone, was remarkable for the Sharks. They dominated play. They controlled the puck. Really importantly, they never turned it over. They didn't make high-risk plays to let the Kings get out of their zone with any ease. I thought a fantastic period from the Sharks. And now we'll see what kind of response the Kings have. We'll see if they can play with more energy, play some of the period in the San Jose zone.
Well, they pressed the reset button, you would think, during the intermission. Gagliardi and Burns had five shots between them. The Kings with only three in the opening period of play. Richards, Carter, and King start up front. We saw in the second half of game three that Daryl Sutter mixed his lines quite a bit, trying to find the right combination. We'll see how quickly he hits the blender switch here in game four. There's Thornton handing it to Carter. Richards has got it. Puts it in the skates of Carter, who couldn't find it. Then Hannon will backhand it out. Hits the bench and bounces out of play. Let's check in with Ryan Rashog.
Chris, I spoke with Kings assistant Bill Ranford at the break. I said, which part of the stats page makes you the most upset? He said, their number of attempts and our lack thereof. If you consider that San Jose had 15 shots on net, they missed the net eight times and had 14 blocked. That's 37 attempts on net. The Kings had just seven. And there you see the zone time, not even close. Los Angeles with half the offensive zone time that San Jose had. Ranford says, we are losing every battle in our own end, and we are not competing.
And it starts with puck possession on the faceoff, and the Sharks much better in that department. Couture with a shot, quick, got another stop there, peppered with two on this shift so far by Logan Couture, Patrick Marleau, and Joe Pavelski. A collision at center, and Couture shaken up by that hit. Hit by Dustin Brown, and Couture to the bench. Now Brown's got it. Here's Dustin Brown to the attack, a backhand off the side of the cage. Williams and Kopitar come up with it. Back to the point, Muzzin stick breaks. And away goes Gomez with Marleau. Gomez replacing the injured Couture. Marleau shot off the glove, and Williams tried to play it back into the goaltender. And that one stayed loose, and the Kings fortunate to get a whistle. We saw Couture leave in the second period of game three, and let's see what happened to him on that hit by Brown.
Well, Couture is shaken up at the bench. He's taken some time. We saw an inadvertent collision in the first period with Marleau and Brown. Brown sees him at the last minute here, and he lays the shoulder right into the middle of Couture's chest. Couture is up and looks like he's just winded as he goes back to the bench.
Was out of game three for about 15 minutes in the second period, and in that span wasn't sure if he could return, really wasn't confident about his return till he took a late shift in the final 30 seconds of that second period, and then showed up for regular duty in the third. Puck shot down the ice right on Niemi, and there's Tyler Toffoli moving in, and a little snow shower will draw some attention for the rookie as James Shepherd tries to get in there.
That's about the second or third time that the Kings have stopped on top of Niemi and sprayed up some snow on top of him. That time it was Toffoli in the first period. Justin Williams and Kopitar got in on him, and Toffoli stops and goes behind the net. It's not really a big deal, but it always seems to fire everybody up. And the Kings trying to get something going here. 21 and a half minutes with three shots on net.
Not their worst period shots on goal-wise. They had a two-shot period against the St. Louis Blues in game three, and yet ended up winning that game 1-0 in overtime. Boyanov off Clifford and deep. Frazier in on the forecheck, knocks down Boyle. Clifford behind the net, can't center against Desjardins. And there's Bracken Kearns trying to pull away, one hands it to center. Slava Voynov on for nine goals for the Kings in the playoffs, just two against. It'll be sent around. Robin Bergier steps up. Clifford behind the net, looks for room. Nobody was available at the right point as the Kings were in the midst of a change. Dowdy there now. Puck stays in the corner. Clifford trying to fish it out of that scrum. Now it's played to the point, and here's Dowdy with a little room. Looks for a shooting lane. Can't find it. That's blocked by Kennedy. Broke his stick. Dowdy, another shot off a skeet in front as Desjardins knocks down his man. Puck to the side of the net, then Boyle there. After a good battle between Fraser and Desjardins in front of the shark net, and Fraser's on it again. Little energy shift by the fourth line that might help the Kings. Blocker stopped by Niemi. Desjardins unable to clear. And finally, fired down the ice by Burns. There's a penalty upcoming as Dowdy back for the icing touch-up. And
after all that hard work, a fabulous shift by the fourth line.
24 LA, 2 minutes roughing.
Colin Fraser takes his second penalty of the night. What an excellent shift for Fraser, Clifford, and Richardson. And Fraser's going to the box here. The third power play for San Jose. I guess that's the roughing penalty, and I can see why Colin Fraser is upset with the call. He made more contact with his teammate than he did with the San Jose penalty. That's not a good call.
2 minutes for leaving your feet?
I'm assuming so, because I can't come up with another one. But what a great shift for the Kings. Their best 5-on-5 shift of the evening by far, and it was by that fourth line group.
Well, the power play has not been razor sharp for the Sharks tonight. So far, the eight groups out along with Couture. There's Thornton. Marlow behind the net. Three Sharks in behind the goal, and now Thornton trying to get it to the point. Broken up by Carter, and he'll get it out. Richardson, Carter start on the kill. And now they're in the midst of a change. At least Richards has gone to the bench, and now Carter will go as well. Couture inside the line. Thornton across. Pavelski waits. Boyle will shoot it. Scores! Tipped in front. 2-0.
Power play goal in game three for Dan Boyle with a point shot from the middle of the ice to get another one here in game four. They take advantage of a soft call, but this starts with Boyle misplaying the puck. Now look how calmly he gets it back and hands it to Couture. The Kings are changing. That gives Couture lots of room to get up the ice. There's another Joe Thornton pass through the feet of the defender. There's the slap shot by Boyle, and you're going to see Couture off the side of the net. It hits his knee and deflects past Jonathan Quick, and the Sharks are up 2-0.
So a pair of power play goals in game three, and now a power play goal to expand the lead 2-0. Here early in the second period, an icing call against the Sharks.
This play starts with Joe Thornton going across the seam. There's the slap shot by Boyle. It's actually going wide, and it hits Couture in the knee and deflects past Jonathan Quick. So the game winner in overtime in game three, and a power play goal here. The Sharks are up 2-0. That's a crucial goal, as they played so well and only had the one to show for it.
Well, our replay shows that glanced off the shin pad of Couture. They are announcing in-house it is a power play goal for Boyle, who scored the opening goal of game three on a power play. Right now it's Boyle from Thornton and Pavelski, and we expect that to change. If it's Couture's goal, it's his fifth of the playoffs. So the Kings, who looked like they'd started better in this second period, now it's a shot by Kopitar off the stick of Niemi. As you mentioned, take that penalty and then give up the second goal. Thornton on it, and he'll head out. Working against Scuderi, dropping for Gagliardi, gets it back, takes a long look. Lewis closed on it, back to Stewart. on the right side for Brent Burns. Brent Burns knocked down by Dowdy. Good battle along the boards. Now Kennedy up with it. Lost control. Scuderi outlets to Pollock. Puts it in front of the net. And now it's flipped ahead to center. Bracken Kearns in the fourth line back out. Drew Dowdy to the red line, sends it deep. Toffoli goes after it. There's Penner on the far side in his 70th Stanley Cup playoff game. Dustin Penner centers it off a ski, wide of the net. Toffoli's on it. Cycles for Lewis. Penner goes to the front of the net. Back to Regier. Slava Voynov into the slot, and that redirected. The puck went through, but the whistle blew, and Dustin Penner is hot.
There's a couple of calls here in the last couple minutes that the Kings are not going to like. This is a quick whistle that goes through Jonathan Quick. Penner standing right on the crease. But the puck went through before Penner puts it in. They've already blown the whistle.
Take a look at it. But the whistle blew. And the Kings robbed of a goal that they desperately needed.
Never stopped when it went through Antti Niemi. What a terrible break for the Kings. Dustin Penner, Trevor Lewis have a terrific shift in the zone. They get the puck to the net, and it's almost like the official guessed that the puck was stopped, but it leaked right through Niemi so quickly it should have never been blown dead.
Kings can't be happy about the Fraser penalty or that quick whistle. Nothing's gone right for them tonight.
And now they're going to have to fight through this. Look, nothing's gone right for them. Their play combined with a couple of calls here in the second period. So now they've got to fight through and see if they can put a couple of shifts back to back here.
And just a little bookkeeping. They have confirmed it was Logan Couture who gets credit for the power play goal.
Chris, one thing that's been of note to me in these playoffs for the Sharks is they just don't take very many penalties. They've been shorthanded 19 times in the playoffs, six of them in game two of this series, the game they gave up three power play goals. They've taken none tonight.
Of course, that was a hotly debated issue in the Vancouver series. Puck out of play, and they'll take the faceoff outside the line. Gives us a chance to remind you the Kraft Celebration Tour is taking SportsCenter on the road, and we want to come to your town. Visit craftcelebrationtour.ca and nominate your community project today. If chosen, your town will receive a $25,000 award and host a live SportsCenter broadcast. Dustin Brown to take the faceoff against Couture. So Couture doesn't miss a shift after that heavy collision with Brown early in the second period. Shovels it ahead. Pavelski to Marlowe. Patrick Marlowe to the attack. Bam on the shot. Rob Scuderi's got it. Can't hook up with Matt Green. Fired across by Marlowe. Justin Braun at the right point. He'll play it in front to the tip. Doesn't get through.
Oh, Jonathan Quick has been good tonight. What a performance he's put on here to hold his team into this game. 20 shots faced already.
On his own. Dowdy. Good pass to Penner. Back in. Kopitar. And that ramps off Vlasic's stick and out of play.
The two best shifts for the Los Angeles Kings have been from their fourth and from their third line. They've got nothing from Kopitar's line nor Mike Richards' line tonight, but they've gotten plenty from Jonathan Quick. Braun shot for the tip here, deflected by Couture, and an excellent right shoulder save by Jonathan Quick. Over 40 shots last game for Quick. They haven't even got to the halfway point, and he's faced 20 again tonight.
Kings win an offensive zone faceoff. Dustin Penner's got it. Trevor Lewis after it in the corner. Bumped with Gomez. Around it goes Wingles. For Shepherd to the red line, and he'll send it in. Off the stick of Toffoli as Irwin closed quickly on him. There's Muzzin. in some difficulty. Shepard centering pass deflects to Toffoli, and he'll start out rolling it in for Penner. Here's Dustin Penner, who sends it across. There's Matt Irwin chopping it away from Lewis. Up the boards, Shepard takes a hit, but gets it ahead to center. Batted back in by Doughty. Matt Irwin ahead. Off Shepard, he wants a change. Out comes Burns. Taps it past Regeer. Thornton swings it around. Gagliardi into the play. Brad Stewart deep for Thornton. There's Richards on Thornton. Stays with it. Another penalty. We've got traffic in front. Gagliardi was all tied up. And it looks like this time it's Gagliardi who's going to go off.
Gagliardi's going to go for interference here as the Kings power play will get their first opportunity of game four. Watch them in front of the net. Gagliardi and Doughty get tangled up. Gagliardi looks like he's trying to get out of the crease, but because the play's in the crease, I assume that's where the interference is both he and Doughty are fighting for position. So the Kings power play that had three goals in game two, nothing in games one and three, could really give themselves a shot in the arm here if they can get one past Antti Niemi.
3-10 in the series. They've scored 5 power play goals in these playoffs. And they go to work with Carter, Kopitar, Richards, Muzzin, and Doughty. And now Stewart's lost his stick. Puck is loose. Stewart down on all fours trying to come up with the puck, or at least hold it and burn some of the clock. Richards up with it. Can't center. Kopitar sends it back to Doughty. There's Jake Muzzin returning it. Doughty to Kopitar into the slot, and Carter's shot off a skeet to the corner. Kopitar gets it back. Doughty returns it. In low for Richards. Centering pass off a stick as Hannon blocked it. Marlowe to the line. It'll be held in by Carter. And now it's Kopitar with it. Richards in front. Kopitar all the way, and he gets buried in front. Brad Stewart on him. Marlowe trying to chip it past Muzzin, and it hits somebody at the Kings bench.
Really strong play by Kopitar taking the puck to the net. We saw in the first period Gagliardi from almost the same spot go to the net. Kopitar sees that seam with Hannon down on the ice defending the pass, and Kopitar tries to drive it to the front of the net to get across the net on Niemi, but is not able to pull the puck across the front of the cage.
Kopitar without a goal against the Sharks this season, including regular season, now into the 8th game. Battle along the boards, and Thornton with Couture get it back down into Kings ice.
Thornton out for the draw, wins the draw. They clear the zone, and then he leaves, and Tommy Wingles replaces him on the ice with Couture.
Toffoli unable to take that pass, and they'll have to reboot the power play once again with just over a half minute remaining. Doughty will lead the rush. Toffoli over the line. Put it in the slot, nobody there. And it'll be cleared once again.
Real interesting group for Daryl Sutter and the Kings. They had three right wingers on the ice. Brown, who took the draw, Williams and Toffoli.
Bracken Kearns gets an opportunity on the kill. Hannon bumped behind the net. It squirts to the side of the goal. Niemi finds it, and he'll hold on with 5 seconds remaining in the Gagliardi penalty as Kyle Clifford and Hannon exchange a shove or two.
We've talked over the last couple of games about the poise of Tyler Toffoli. He has not made many mistakes with the puck. Here he thinks he sees something in the middle of the ice. It's almost like a hope play. He wants to go across the ice to Brown, but there's no way that puck's going to get across there. And that's a young mistake for Toffoli. At that point, he's got to hang on to the puck, take the hit, absorb the contact, and move the puck down low so they can reboot the power play.
So 5 seconds remain as Lewis hunkers down against Thornton on this faceoff. Thornton wins another. 6-1 in the opening period. Stewart kicks it ahead. Couture takes a bump, but sends it the length of the ice as Gagliardi returns. Past the midway mark of the second period, Couture diving over the boards. They nearly got caught with too many men. Now knocked down by Gagliardi. May have been played with a glove. And play is halted as Thornton was first to touch it. So the Sharks kill the first power play of the game for the Kings. Continue to lead 2-0.
TJ Gagliardi's become a real irritant in this series to the Kings. Here he gets an interference penalty. He and Drew Doughty have been going at it most of the series. And then here he clips the foot of Jonathan Quick. Quick dives after Gagliardi ties his foot up. But Gagliardi's become a thorn a little bit in the side of Jonathan Quick and Drew Doughty. And there has to be a line for Gagliardi as well, though. He's got to be aware that he gets into the goal crease there. That easily can be a penalty called on him. There's not going to be one called on Quick on that play.
Todd McClellan's instruction to his team, don't be careful, but be aware that the referees are watching. In particular, that crease after the post discussions of game three.
And that would have been a pretty good example of what McClellan wouldn't want. I mean, you've got to be aware of where you are on the ice. Gagliardi's into the goal crease halfway. He's lucky he doesn't get a penalty call.
Close captioning is brought to you by Steel. Built to last. Price to sell. Well, if you joined us late, it has been domination by the Sharks here in game four tonight. The shots 20-7. A 2-0 lead, but you still get the feeling one goal by the Kings could quickly get them back in this game. They've had some misfortune. A goal they thought they had scored, negated by a quick whistle.
And the penalty that they took on the power play goal was one that they wouldn't like. It was a soft call against Colin Fraser. The Sharks made them pay.
Matt Green ahead, sends it across to Muzzin. He'll fire it around. Colin Fraser goes after it. Cannon swept it away, and Andrew Desjardins got some room. Kennedy trails. He's got it. Takes a look across, but can't center against Scuderi. Now Bracken Kearns battles. Leaned on by Clifford. Stays with it. And Kennedy in support. He'll cycle it back in that corner. Kearns is headed off on a change. Up for Fraser at center. Fraser's penalty came after a good shift by the fourth line, but now it's Pavelski to the attack, and a glove stop by Quick, and a beauty off Joe Pavelski.
Oh, another excellent stop for Jonathan Quick at the end of a shift. Kyle Clifford wants to get off the ice. He just blows a shoe here a little bit. Now he decides to change. When he changes, that leaves the middle of the ice wide open for Pavelski to skate in, and Jonathan Quick up on top of the blue. A glove stop as Pavelski wants to get it up over top of the glove. He doesn't. And Quick keeps the game at 2-0.
And is the biggest and only reason you think the Kings still have a chance here in game four. Vlasic bounces it to the side of the net. Doughty takes a look. Wants Dustin Brown, knocked off his stick, and now the Kings get it out to center.
Well, Chris, Daryl Sutter was telling you this morning about how the big boys have to play. These series are decided by the best players, and the best players in this game have been in black sweaters by far.
Vlasic drifts that shot wide. Gagliardi off the bench into the fray once again. He'll get hooked by Kopitar. That one goes uncalled. And now Williams up for Brown. Seen TJ Gagliardi hit the deck a lot this series, and maybe that's the reason that one was ignored.
And you built your own reputation. He goes down pretty quickly, and he doesn't get the call there.
Kopitar up top. His shot wide of the net. There's Justin Williams looking for it. Back to Green. His shot right on. Rebound. Vlasic clears from the front of the net. Little push here, and now Dustin Penner's got it. In the midst of a change, Williams to the bench. Plays it back in behind the net. Better shift by the Kopitar line that time. Now it's center. Matt Green on TJ Gagliardi. And again, the officials here in the crowd want a penalty, but the men with the red armband say no penalty.
Gagliardi went down twice on this shift. Here's the first one as Kopitar gives him a little shove. You see his stick by his foot, but Gagliardi goes down with a little bit too much histrionics for a call to be made. And then on that last icing call, Matt Green gets up behind him. As soon as Gagliardi feels the pressure, he goes down again.
Poyna fired the shot. That was knocked down en route. That took a bite out of the ankle of Marc-Edouard Vlasic, who plays the puck nonetheless. It's closed down on the one side by Carter. Braun will send it the other way, and Gagliardi gets hit again.
I can guarantee you the guys on the Kings bench are furious with Gagliardi right now.
Here's Voinov picking off a pass, moving in, shot, and he fired it high. It whistled past the right ear of Antti Niemi. So the Kings back-to-back good shifts. See if they gathered some momentum. A hit on Wingles as he fires it in. Quick out of the net, and now James Sheppard took it away. Puck follows Sheppard back along the boards. Gets it to Gomez. Gloves it down. A pass to the point. Comes outside the line. Hannon will fire it back in. 5:05 left here in the second period. 2-0 for San Jose. Toffoli drops it in. Lewis punished by Hannon. Marlowe up the boards. Sent ahead. Too far for Couture. Dwight King forward to Foley and across. Here's Lewis. Lewis over the line. Dumped it into the corner. Kings are changing, and Hannon works it ahead. Robin Regier for Matt Green. Green sends it in. There's Clifford arriving on the scene. Richardson there as well. Bracken Kearns has it chopped off his stick. Richardson, Fraser, that shot blocked by Marc-Edouard Vlasic. Now a pass off a skate, and it's turned back in by Clifford. Here's Clifford and Richardson. Brad Richardson to the point. Rob Scuderi sends it deep. Here's Kyle Clifford, tracked by Kennedy. Behind the net for Fraser, watched by Irwin. Richardson after it against Kennedy. Scuderi has it hop on him, and he'll have to reboot out at center. Bouncing puck, and Fraser headed to the bench will swat it back in. Stretch pass finds Burns at the Kings line. Here's Jake Muzzin. Under 3.5 minutes left in the second period. Doughty off Williams and deep. See if the Kopitar line can follow up a good shift the last time out. It'll be Muzzin shooting right on, and the rebound will be cleared by Burns.
Now we're seeing some of the byproduct of when you scramble like the Kings did in the first period. The Sharks just giving the puck away, not making that simple 1-2 breakout. Now they take another penalty.
Hannon on Kopitar. So when we come back, the Kings will be on the power play, trying to cut into it. 2-0 San Jose lead.
Second power play of the period here for the Los Angeles Kings. Scott Hannon called for interference on Andrei Kopitar. Goes without saying, a crucial moment here for the Kings if they can wedge their way into this lead. They've played better here the last 5 or 7 minutes of this period. Have nothing to show yet.
Kopitar, Richards, Carter, Doughty, Muzzin. Looking to break through for the first time tonight against Antti Niemi. Muzzin holds, looks rink wide. Richards with room, fires, knocked down in front. Loose puck, and it's fired high. Oh, how did Muzzin miss that? Looked like the net was open for Jake Muzzin from point blank range.
Jake Muzzin will not get an easier look at a net. 7 goals in the regular season for Muzzin. You'll see him come off the back door. The puck's gonna bounce to him right here, and it rolls just up on top of its edge. Watch Muzzin again. just him in the empty net, and he shoots it straight into the netting, not only over the net, but into the netting, as the Kings miss a glorious chance.
You're right, the rolling puck late in the period, and the Kings haven't been able to buy one yet. Carter left wing, Richards holds, now finds Kopitar wide open. Back to Doughty, breaks his stick, and now Couture's away. Will attack his old buddy from London. And Doughty with a good check to slow him up. Final minute of this power play. Kopitar back in. Irwin wouldn't let him by, and the Kings are turned back. Under 2 minutes left here in the second period. Kings need one to get within one and get some momentum for the third. Trevor Lewis up the middle and then passed off out of the reach of Williams. Slavovoynov. Rob Scuderi returns it. Williams is up high. Scuderi tries to get it to him. It does arrive. Now Lewis and Williams trade spots. Point shot, Voynov, and that glanced off a leg well wide. Lewis goes after it. Tied up in the corner, kicked it loose for Brown. There's Brad Stewart winning a battle. Warding off Brown and then losing it to Lewis. Brown pins him, Lewis gets it back. Dying seconds of the power play. Voynov with it, his shot sails high. Williams after it. Final minute of the period, and out of the box comes Hannon. So the Kings are 0 for 2 on the night and still down by 2. That comes off a skate, back to Voynov again. Sends it to the side of the net. Brown lost possession of it. Up for Hannon. And sent back in by Williams. Finally flipped out, and both teams will make changes in the final half minute. Robin Regier ahead on the left side. After it goes Fraser. Penner's on this near wing. And Desjardins sends it the length of the ice. A dozen seconds left. That puck takes a funny hop, but now is cleared. Sent back in by Kennedy. Stopped up by Quick. As the clock drains in the second period, Sharks are going to have a 2-goal lead headed to the third. Power play goal for Logan Couture. 2-0 after two. Here again, James Duffy and our panel. 2-0 after two periods of play. We talked about TJ Gagliardi, Brent Burns, Joe Thornton in the first period. Did not have a shot on goal in the second period, but TJ Gagliardi very much the center of attention anyway.
Yeah, he was, man. Has he become a pain in the rear end of the Los Angeles Kings? He was flopping around the ice like an Olympic diver. In the second period, he was down a half a dozen times. And after the second one, as they call the icing penalty, you're going to see the official, Chris Rooney, go by the bench, say, nah, he's diving. That's why the icing call was made. So this is going to continue. Joe Thornton wants to know what's going on. And the officials don't like when the players dive because they feel it puts them in a bad position. Todd McClellan is telling him, when you make the diving symbol, you make my player look bad. So the argument continues, the discussion continues, everybody trying to play for a little edge somewhere along the line, and Gagliardi is going to have to stay on his feet a little bit more if he wants to draw one of those penalties later on.
So we start the third period. The Sharks with a 2-goal lead, trying to even this series at 2 games apiece. But despite the domination, you just get this funny feeling the Kings are a shot away from engineering a comeback. That puck gets past Penner down the ice. Regier after it against Thornton. And now Carter will pick up the loose puck in his own zone. Richards redirects to center, and the Kings will make their first change of this third period. Dustin Penner started that shift on the line with Carter and Richards, so Darryl Sutter starting to change things up a little bit. Kopitar, Brown, and Williams stay together as Marlowe takes a shot to the near side for Braun. Along the boards, Marlowe chips it deeper. Kopitar sends it around to the far side. Vlasic awaits. Deflects up into the air, gloved by Scuderi, and it would come outside the line and a hit there. And on the domino effect, Williams got the worst of that. Up for Brown, off his stick, and Kopitar goes after it. Niemi tries to shovel it. Kopitar centers right off Niemi. James Shepard there defensively. Muzzin's moved up. Here's Jake Muzzin centering it and got past Brown and all the way out. So we saw Muzzin on that shift, and Daryl Sutter wants his defense to be active in this series, and probably more so down by two here in the third. And an icing call against San Jose. Let's check in with Ryan Mashog.
Yeah, Chris, just continuing on the Gagliardi storyline, I talked with Sharks assistant Jim Johnson at the break. They talked to him between periods and they said, look, they're obviously watching you. Be careful in the crease. They also told him, we need you to stay on your feet, stay engaged in the game. Don't let any of this get to you. Just keep playing. So definitely a storyline in that second period, Chris. We'll see how Gagliardi handles it in the third here.
Gagliardi with an assist on the opening goal of the game by Brent Burns. Logan Couture scored on a power play in the second period. That's where we stand. A faceoff win by Richards. Carter, a shot right on. James Shepard up for Gomez and in. So Dustin Penner back with Richards and Carter. A line that was very effective last year in the Stanley Cup run at times.
Penner played just under 8 minutes in the first two periods, and why that's significant is Daryl Sutter doesn't like to play him more than 13 or 14 minutes. He doesn't feel like he has the energy to give, so he's in a good spot here if they want to use him more minutes. I thought he had a very effective second period for the Kings.
He was victimized by that quick whistle that cost the Kings a goal in the second period. Back to get it, Matt Green. Up ahead, out of the reach of Toffoli. Now it's Toffoli, Richardson, and Fraser. A new combination for Daryl Sutter. The Power of Canada's number one news source. Your news, your channel. CTV News Channel.
We talked about Penner up with Carter and Richards, and King, Lewis, and Clifford are going to be the third line for LA. This is their fourth line, a reconstructed unit as Toffoli drops down. Fraser and Richardson, who have been effective tonight, are going to play together, it looks like, here in the, at least at the start of the third period.
On the faceoff, Fraser able to win it from his knees, and there's Toffoli. The youngster plays it to the line, and then it's scooped back out by San Jose. Dan Boyle with it. A bank pass and a little room for Bracken Kearns. His shot goes wide as Kennedy looked for the redirect. Kearns intercepts that breakout pass, but now the Kings are away. Voinov unable to get through. Now a quick turn by Voinov. He'll leave it for Kopitar. His shot is blocked. Kopitar to the corner. Chips it for Brown. There's Kopitar. Williams is in front of the net. Voinov shot, and that's blocked. En route. A save there by Couture. Apparently Logan Couture is an old ball hockey goaltender, likes to play goal, and showed you a little of it there as he made a save. Puck out of play, and I think that one stung a bit.
Yeah, he's taking a little spin around the ice as he tries to get rid of the stinger to his right hand. Here he is in front of the net, and you mentioned the old ball hockey goalie. He makes a blocker stop. That has to hurt. 51 blocks in the regular season for Couture, who's headed right down the tunnel again for the Sharks. That's a couple of times in tonight's game, plus the once in game three the other night.
Pavelski wins the faceoff, and Wingles will deflect it out. Kings were better in the faceoffs in the second period, but the Sharks have won 60% on the night. Here's that group you were talking about, Clifford with Lewis and King, put together by Daryl Sutter for this third period of play. Gomez hounding quick. Drew Doughty's got it. Couture has returned to the Shark bench. Now King over the line. Clifford a weak shot Turned aside by Niemi. And now Brad Stewart. Brent Burns advances. 11 shots for the Kings in the game. There's Thornton. He scoops it in front. Richards intercepted that, then flips it high. Penner trying to skate onto it. Up against Justin Braun. There's Carter taking Thornton to the corner. Richards arrives, gets it back to Scuderi. Across for Green, a shot, and that one whistled wide. Ricochets to Scuderi, a shot with Carter providing a screen in front. A push here by the Kings. Scuderi centers again. Penner looks for it. Carter couldn't reach it. And Vlasic off the boards and out.
Two stops at Niemi made. He didn't see the puck through the Carter screen. Excellent shift for Richards and Carter.
Richards turns it over. Couture shot. Quick got a piece of that. Pavelski up with it. Penalty pending against the Kings as Couture was caught with a high stick. They'll check for damage. And Matt Green's headed off.
The Sharks with a chance to put the real dagger in here off the turnover. Couture's shot is stopped, and then the high stick by Matt Green rides up the arms of Couture, and he clips him here. Couture is all right, and the Sharks with a chance to really stretch this out on LA here.
Fourth power play of the game for the Sharks. They're 1-for-3. Couture, the goal scorer. Thornton wins the faceoff from Kopitar. Dan Boyle, Marlowe, the point man. And there's Marlowe. His shot is blocked. Regier in the shooting lane, and Dustin Brown will backhand it deep. Regier to the bench, and out comes Scuderi. Here's Marlowe to the attack. Broken up. And they'll have to reorganize at center. Thornton to Boyle. Boyle back in. Fires it around off the glass, and it's deflected and off a King stick and out. 6 minutes into the third. ...70 seconds of power play time as Gomez dances through center. Gomez over the line, slowed up, and it's batted back out. Thornton. And that pass hits somebody and deflects away. And now here's Mike Richards, shorthanded. Richards can't pull the trigger. Out for Gagliardi. They'll try and counter here. 3-on-2. Thornton, Gagliardi, Gomez wide. Back in for Thornton, and went all the way to goaltender Quick. Brad Richardson now skates out. Voinov is hopped up. 2-on-2, and Voinov taking the pass and getting a shot away. And Niemi will hold on to that. As Richardson got hit and the glove went flying.
Yeah, Brent Burns got him in the middle of the ice. The players were telling us about Burns on the forecheck when he moved to forward, how he'll race in, turn around, and hit him with their backside. This looks a lot like a Rob Blake check when Blake was with the Kings early in his career. He comes right across the middle. He turns backwards and he lays it into Richardson here. Richardson fortunately is okay as Niemi makes the stop, as Richardson drops the puck and there's nowhere to go as Burns is close tightly on him.
That's an abrupt, painful stop, isn't it?
That is 20 miles an hour to zero.
Brick wall.
Half of a second as Burns just turned his backside into him, and that really is the Rob Blake check that I saw so much of when you played against him, and then when I played with him. Devastating hit.
Burns runs into a roadblock named Regier, who broke his stick and tosses it towards the bench as he goes off. We're past 7 minutes of the third period. Dying seconds of a short power play. Fired in where Doughty is unable to clear. Scuderi will try it, and that skitters off the glass and out.
Excellent kills for the Kings when the Sharks have had a chance to stretch the lead. They've done the job when they've needed to here.
Here's Couture working in. Shot wide as he went to the forehand, and now Clifford will turn it with Dwight King. Unable to deflect it deep. Right off the bench, Jake Muzzin finds the puck. Gets it to Kopitar. Andre Kopitar, a shot, and Niemi Got a piece of that. Along the boards, King with a hit, and Muzzin steps up. Now Kyle Clifford. Kopitar, Clifford, and King. And Jake Muzzin moves up. Took a look. There was a loose man in front, and he lost the puck. Now cycles it back into the corner. King takes a hit. Got it to Kopitar. Muzzin, no shot. Now Voinov has it. Bank off Shepard into the corner. Kopitar flat in there. Penalty upcoming. And Brent Burns will go off for that hit on Andre Kopitar. Kopitar slow to get up, and the Kings will go on the power play. Brent Burns headed off after that.
Dustin Brown doesn't have a shot tonight. He's been moved to the second power play unit for the Kings. That first group will get the opportunity to start the power play. Kopitar's in the middle of it. Just one goal in his last 25 games for Kopitar. He's drawn a couple of penalties tonight, and the Kings need one here.
And the Kings with only 6 goals in 4 road games coming into tonight, looking for their first of the evening. And Kopitar's faceoff comes all the way back.
Joe Thornton helps him go down the ice. The way the Kings are lined up, there's nobody at that point. Thornton sees the opening as Kopitar draws it back. He pushes the puck with him, and the Kings have to regroup.
Dowdy sends it right wing. There's Kopitar dashing in. Stewart closes on him. Richards from this corner. Back to Kopitar. Carter goes to the front of the net. Dowdy and Muzzin, the point man. But a chance Muzzin had on the last power play. Carter centers, loose in front, and just disrupting it in time was Pavelski. With Kopitar loose at the back door. Here's Richards. Shot is blocked by Brad Stewart. Muzzin across. Dowdy. Back to Muzzin. He'll fire it. The net hit a King on route off Richards. Plays it into the corner. Muzzin moves down low. It gets past Kopitar. Dowdy after it against Pavelski and beats him to the puck. Sent around to Muzzin on the near side. There's Richards taking over. Mike Richards walking in and then sent it into the far corner. Into the second minute of the power play. Good control, but no shots through on Niemi yet. Richards to set it up again. Dowdy returns it to Richards. Kopitar, Carter, quick shot. That one blocked by Pavelski. Carter again, off the post, rebound, scores! And the Los Angeles Kings are within one on a power play goal by Mike Richards.
Well, after a terrific shift, penalty killing wise from Joe Pavelski, who's limping his way back to the Sharks bench. Carter takes a rebound to hit the goal post, and then Mike Richards gets himself from below the goal line to the top of the net. There's the save by Pavelski off the Carter first shot. There's the goal post, and then Richards, who's below the goal line, gets his stick in front of the goal line to bank this in. If Richards stays back there, there's no goal. He banks this one in off of Niemi. And the Kings, with the power play goal, their fourth of the series, are back in it with 10 minutes left.
They've outshot the Sharks 7-1 in the third period. So the game's on. 9:46, the time of the power play goal. Mike Richards, second of the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Richards hasn't had a great year on the road this year. Daryl Sutter pointed out early in the year they had to work him in with some other lines as he had to check more, just 12 of his 32 points on the road this year. But Richards continues his fine playoff for the Kings.
Now a quick shot through a screen. Niemi found it at the last second to make the save. And just like that, it's the Sharks on their heels a bit. But to the attack goes Gomez. Puts on the brakes, looks for a late man, and now just cycles it behind the net. There's Justin Williams. After the power play, Williams out with Lewis and Penner. And here's Trevor Lewis sending it in. It's called on the offside. We're past the midway mark of the third period. And now a one-goal game in game 4.
Yeah, get another look at the goal. Pavelski makes the first block. The puck bounces right to Kopitar, so Pavelski is helpless. And Brad Stewart goes to block the shot behind Pavelski. That leaves room for Richards to get a couple of whacks at it. The second one bounces off of Antti Niemi. And now we'll see if the Sharks can compose themselves a little bit. We talked in that first period, Chris, how nothing was clean for the Kings coming out of their zone. The Sharks haven't cleanly exited their zone in some time as the Kings start to put the pressure on.
Since the 2010 Stanley Cup playoffs, no player has more points than Mike Richards in playoff competition. 54 points for Richards after the goal tonight.
Really has a way to elevate his game at playoff time. He really seems to like the biggest of stages. There are times in the regular season where he'll kind of wander in and out a little bit. But when the games are big, Mike Richards seems to have a way to get it done.
Couture against Kopitar on this faceoff to the right of Jonathan Quick.
So Clifford out on this line now with Brown and Kopitar.
Dustin Braun moves up, trying to hold the zone, backed up by Couture. Banned on that shot, but Braun gets it, fires it across. Marleau goes after it. There's Pavelski. Tracked by Regier, swung it in front all the way back to the right point. Braun shot, leaked through off Kopitar, and now away goes Dustin Brown. He can't get across the line, and the Sharks send it back in. So a decent chip for the Couture line to at least try and stem the Kings' momentum here. But Kopitar now to the attack, swooping in and curling it across through the blue paint. Brown's on it. Scuderi now at the left point. Sends it deep. Ange Kopitar. Slowed up by Hannon. Thornton will get control along the boards, and there's Clifford to knock it loose. Hannon back to Thornton. A dangerous outlet. Burns was there, but still dangerous. That's a lot of confidence, is it?
That's a 1,000-point guy right there, putting it through his own legs right in front of his net.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Steel. Built to last. Price to sell.
I know one centerman that wouldn't ever had the guts to do this play. Between his own feet, 50 feet across the crease to Brent Burns, and they're out of the zone.
He must have the lowest pulse rate on the ice right now. Carter shot off that faceoff that glances off the skate to Pannon. Now a chop at it by Carter and a shot right on, and there's Dustin Penner. Again, Penner moving up on this line with Richards and Carter in the third period. Jamming along the boards. Burns trying to fish it out. Thornton in the midst of the fray. Comes loose for Brad Stewart. There's Doughty moving up from the corner. A sharp angle off Niemi. Into the skates of Carter, and now Burns one hands it out to trigger a sharp change. Muzzin across, and Doughty returns it to Muzzin to the attack over the line. Justin Williams shot, and that one got through and didn't miss by much. Jake Muzzin, Slava Voynov, looking for Justin Williams on the right side. That pass doesn't work. Matt Irwin gets it to Boyle. Boyle off the boards to the line. Williams trying to hold it in, but it does come out. Fired back in by Voynov, and Niemi will hold on to that. Exactly 7 minutes left in regulation time.
The scrutiny is always going to be on calls that went your way or did not. This was in the second period. The point shot by Voynov was tipped by Trevor Lewis. The puck went right through. You'd see Brad Meyer telling Dustin Penner the faceoff is right here to the left of Niemi, and the puck never stopped its momentum as it went into Niemi's equipment and went right through him, and the Kings will hate that call as long as they look at it.
You see the domination by the Kings here in the third period. 11-1 the shots. They look up ice, a pass got by Marleau, and now a race for it. Robin Regier got there first. An icing call, so we saw the disallowed goal, and the Kings also had that great chance on a power play by Jake Muzzin.
Muzzin walks into the slot, and the puck, after hitting the traffic in front of the net, got up on end, and Muzzin's about 4 feet from the net, and he hits the underside of the puck and ended up in the netting way above the Sharks' goal in a wide-open net that Muzzin wasn't able to cash.
And prior to all of that, some game savers by Jonathan Quick to keep it a two-goal deficit. Now down by one, but still time for the Kings to extend this game. Under 6.5 left as Carter gets to the red line, shoots it in off the blocker of Niemi, and that's out of play, so they'll get a face-off deep in Shark ice.
It is so obvious when you see a team starting to get a little tight. When they have chance to move the puck stick to stick out of the zone, the defenseman will often take the off the glass and out. The problem with that is now you've just given up possession again. Sometimes you have to. That's the only play you have. But the Sharks have stopped making direct tape-to-tape passes in their zone. As a result, Chris, as you just talked about, the shots are 11-1, and the Sharks are on their heels.
Face-off win by Kopitar. Green shot doesn't get through. One shot in the third period. They had 15 in the opening frame. Joe Thornton really set the tone. Now a pass, and Burns bumped off the puck by Kopitar. Rob Scuderi, an outlet on the right side, and now Williams ahead. There's Dustin Brown over the line into the skates of Kopitar. Deep it goes. Brown let it go. Williams behind the net, trying to pivot away from Scott Gomez. Kopitar. Green had a little trouble with it. Sent it to the corner. Gomez there for the Sharks. And up and out, but Green will fire it right back in. Kings will change as Justin Braun starts out. Stretch pass looking for Desjardins. That didn't work. Matt Irwin trying to clear the zone. There's Irwin along the boards. Puck bounces free into the skates of Gomez, and Desjardins will take over and get it out of harm's way. Regier back in his own zone, pressured by Wingles. White King high up in the air and into Shark ice, and there's Kyle Clifford arriving first. Couture off the boards. Pavelski gloved it down, but can't clear it. White King is there. Now Boyle off the boards and out, and they're going to wave icing. Marlowe is going to get there first anyway. Patrick Marlowe tied up by Regier, but Dustin Penner there to help out. King start back. Carter to the center ice area. They get caught in the change. Couture in, and he fired that wide. Kings were changing, and that one knocked down by Boyle at center ice, and a quick counter by San Jose. Muzzin sends it in. Under 4.5 minutes left. There's Mike Richards, the Kings goal scorer. Brent Burns has a goal for San Jose. Penner's got it, and he swung it to the right point out of the reach of Doughty. Back and Kearns a steal, a backhand, and off a stick into the corner.
Kearns out as Gagliardi got nicked in the face a little earlier. He's getting tended to on the Shark bench, but Kearns with his best chance of the night.
And now James Sheppard checks in. He'll take Gagliardi's spot. There's Sheppard with it. And Gomez is on the ice, and he'll dash through center. Gomez drops. Wingles a weak shot under the glove of Quick and wide. Braun held it momentarily, but now Brad Richardson heading in. Pass for Toffoli, looks to get it back to Richardson, and he was shadowed there by Braun. Toffoli feeds the point. Rob Scuderi across. Matt Green shot, and that whistles wide. Scuderi moves up. Niemi holds the short side, makes the save. Pressure again by the Kings. Into the skates of Braun. Now it's Vlasic in some difficulty, and they'll just bounce it down the ice. It'll go wide of the net. Green back to touch, an icing call with 3:06 remaining in the third period. Well, the NHL on TSN Stanley Cup playoffs continues Thursday with a doubleheader. First up, Game 4, Bruins and Rangers, and then Game 5 of this series, Sharks and Kings, another full night to playoff hockey. Gets underway Thursday, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. On TSN and TSN Mobile TV, and a timeout being taken by the Sharks.
So the Sharks have their third line on the ice, Sheppard, Wingles, and Scott Gomez. Gomez will have to take the faceoff here. It's on his weak side of the ice. You would suspect that the Kings would go with Kopitar, who is on the ice now, to take the draw against him. None of the Kings coaches are talking to the Kings. The Kings veteran players are standing in a group. It's the Kopitar line. They know what they want to get accomplished. There's no play diagram there. Todd McClellan and their staff, you see that they're talking to their players and wanting to make sure everybody knows on a face-off one, where are our outlets? On a face-off lost, where do we need to go to cover off the shots that we need? And it'll be Kopitar and Gomez on the draw.
Something I didn't expect to say tonight based on the quick start by the Sharks. Kings now outshooting the Sharks in the game.
The incredible change in the pace of the game.
They've got the puck. There's Williams trying to sift it through, loose in the slot. And now Muzzin steps up. Jake Muzzin pushes it in behind the net and goes after it. Comes up with it. Back to his defensive partner, Doughty, returning it. Doughty's shot doesn't get through. Gets his own rebound. Wheeling in on the backhand. Swivels in, brought it off a skate. That nearly baked in. Off Vlasic, and now a sprawling play by Shepherd to bounce it down the ice. And is it going to be an up for icing? Yes. With 2:29 remaining in the third period. Our game story brought to you by Molson Canadian, proud partner of the NHL. Molson Canadian, made from Canada.
Joe Thornton was fabulous in the first 20 minutes. He had an assist as the Sharks got off to that great lead on the terrific first period. Logan Couture scored a power play goal in the second. You see how close the Kings come there as that puck hit Vlasic's skate and deflected wide.
Carter wins the faceoff. Voinov at the right point. Puts it in behind the net. Again, Penner with Richards and Carter as the puck off of Voinov and down into LA ice.
Well, what an escape for the Sharks as the Gomez line had been out there for well over a minute and a half, even with the timeouts.
Richards sends it in again. Cannon back. Looked like he got crossed up with Stewart. It's played across by Richards. Voinov, slot, Carter, loads, fires, but the shot doesn't get through. Couture with the bank, and Marlowe's got a break. Patrick Marlowe in, and Jonathan Quick well out beyond the blue paint to make that stop. Time for our electric player of the game. It's brought to you by Chevrolet. Find new roads.
Despite a dominant 30 minutes by the Los Angeles Kings, Joe Thornton owned the first part of the game. In the first period, he played about as good a period of hockey as I've seen Joe Thornton play, whether it was on the faceoff, whether it was controlling the puck in the offensive zone, setting up Brent Burns for the game's first goal. A couple of magical plays with his great passing skill. Your electric player is Joe Thornton.
Now out to take this offensive zone faceoff against Trevor Lewis. Kings prevail. There's Jake Muzzin knocked away. TJ Gagliardi back on the flank with Thornton. Gagliardi knocks it down. Burns in front. He tried to get it to Thornton. Gagliardi unable to get it through on the backhand. And now Dwight King rolls it in. Kings out there with Clifford and Lewis. And the Sharks able to deflect it out. 80 seconds left in regulation time. King hit by Marlowe. Kopitar follows up. Clifford looks for a loose puck. Skinneri's shot, and that goes wide as Jonathan Quick has left the net for an extra attacker. Dustin Braun along the boards. The Kings' net is empty. Couture plays it past Skinneri and out. San Jose. Puck fired around the board. Pavelski can't find it. Doughty up with it. Kopitar goes to the corner. Now loose for Thornton, and he'll flip it out and roll it down. Up off Brown and deep again, and the first man to it could be Carter. No, Boyle beat him to the puck. Boyle after it on the near side. That was knocked down by Brown. Gets it to Kopitar. They've got 15 seconds left. Looking for the equalizer. Kopitar centering pass off a skate. There's a chance for Burns in the corner to clear. Brent Burns will get it out. And we'll head to Los Angeles with this series even at two games apiece. So the Sharks hold serve, and it's now a best of three. Final score in game four, San Jose 2, Los Angeles 1. So long from the HP Pavilion. The great Dan O'Toole and SportsCenter is next.